how?
I asked Deepak to tell some words.
Good morning, friends. Jesse Krishna, that's what we call in our ashram where I come from. First of all, of course, all the members of the dais, the committee members, friends, many friends we have already met in Kenya, Granada, India. So this has been an ongoing process. And when I was told by Celestino that we would like to meet this time in Faro again, for me it's the second time, I was very happy because actually we had planned to do the Solakuka International Meet in India this year. And for some reason we had to postpone it to next year. So there was a big gap. So it was just right time to fill in. And I'm glad that we met because yesterday I was just talking to a friend who came from USA, and even in our own mind kept on asking, is it really necessary to have so many conferences? Because we keep on meeting the same people again and again and keep on repeating, and in process of saving carbon dioxide, we produce more carbon dioxide. But when I went back and slept, I thought, look, maybe yes, we do produce carbon dioxide. Every time you do anything, we produce carbon dioxide. But it's the effort to save CO2 which counts. And maybe a lot of things can be done on Skype, Facebook, WhatsApp. But the personal chemistry that happens when we meet is no way a replacement. And I think that bond, the relationship, the bridges which are built, that just coming to Faro, coming via Spain, it has removed so many fears from our mind. You know, this human bond, the human bridge which is created. And the learning and sharing which happens when we talk to each other is a lot more than we care. And for me, a conference does not happen in conference hall. The conference happens outside the conference hall. I don't want you to rush out now. Please stay here and hear us out. But yes, please use the opportunity to look for people of your interest, someone who you can learn from, somewhere you can go and share. And let us continue this process. For me, this conference is going to be the biggest challenge because I have to do two things. I have to not speak the Indian accent, and I have to speak slowly. If I try to speak slow, I forget what I have to say. But I think we will manage. It's a great effort, and I'm glad to see so many people. When we started, we were not counting on so many people, and not only numbers, but I see that the people from different parts of countries, you know, continents. We have people from South Africa, from USA, from Africa, India. Of course, we are a big gang. Someone said Indian invasion. But I think it's a better invasion than other things. And important is we will go in next 2 days learning, again getting in touch with each other and building upon what we built. And hopefully next year we can meet you in India when we have a meeting for Solakuka International. Julie is here. We've been talking about it, how to take it forward and plan. So we look forward to a very interesting few days, and we are glad that after this 2 days conference, the next day we have birthday of our friend Celestino. So we celebrate the conference ending with solar birthday. Ever since I met him, I think he's not just interested in solar, he's possessed with solar. I think he does not eat food, he eats solar energy. Every time you see him, he's either carrying a solar cooker, anywhere he goes, he opens the cooker, makes cakes, distributes food. And I think we all have to have a tinge of craziness to take it forward. It's no more a hobby. It has to be a very serious matter, and we need to work with our heart, not just with hand. Thank you very much, Jesse Krishna.